welcome back to Tony Northeastern. Yes, it's me on the screen. That makes a change, doesn't it? Now, why am I on the screen? Well, we're doing something a little bit different. We're taking a break from building Tiny Dog Station, only a small break, just to bring you this video. Over the past year or so, the subscriber rate has gone up quite high, and it's because of a recent subscriber. He wants to see all the stations. So what we'll do a tour of the stations in the order that they were built, which is going to be interesting because I've not done that before. Normally when I do a tour, I just do a running session and not explain their history and the ins and outs and my thoughts about these stations. So we're going to start this tour off over there, which is Newhassox. That was the first station to be put down, as it were. Well, the platforms were. So let's have a look at that one first. We have six stations on this layout, and this was the first one to have its platforms put down on the baseboards. And this is Newhassox. It was kind of rushed together because I wanted to get on with Tyne Dock, so I'm not overly happy about what I've done here. Let me explain. The best thing I like about this building is the main building, and that's the Fala kit, based on the Bonn station in Germany. And I didn't do a lot to this kit, except I changed a lot of the concrete, the concrete looking chimney breasts, as it were, and swapped them for brick ones. And I think it gave it a more British authenticity, is the word I'm looking for. And hence why, if and when I decide to revamp the station, this building will stay, but I will adapt the station side to hold a new train shed roof, which is going to take the place of this pico oval roof. There's two kits there, so that will be discarded, and a new train shed roof will be the same width, but it'll cover all the platforms. And then maybe here, from this point onwards, we'll have the low relief platform covers. One thing I do like about this station is the size. It just takes up all of the baseboard. The baseboard itself is only 2.5 foot wide, and we've got at least four big platforms there, and then we've got the bay platform here, which serves the South Shields branch. You can tell this station's not finished because I've only got two Newhassox signs up. There should be one on each of the platforms, and this one should have change for South Shields or something like that here. But yeah, so as we look around, we can see the footbridge there, which spans all the platforms. That's a Daypole kit. That will stay. I'll not get rid of that. So yeah, that was, I think that was two or three kits combined to make that long footbridge. And I had to raise it as well. I had to raise it by another 3 or 4 millimeters so trains could clear underneath it. But yeah, so that's a good view down there. We don't often get the camera this close in. The back scene, as you can see, is totally faded away. There's a bit of a mixture of the town and the old terraced houses. So what I'll probably do there, I'll just make up a succession of kits to run along that back wall to hide that. But yeah. Before we move on to the next station, I just wanted to show you this view of the station underneath the canopy there. You know, you see why I need to change this. It just does not look as good as the station we'll see later on, and hence why we've got to come back to Newcastle to change the appearance and bring it up to date. Right, so that's Newcastle. And here we are at station 2. Now I know a lot of you will be shouting, I don't know where you are. You're at Tyne Dock, and you're right, because Tyne Dock was the second station to be built on this layout, and it's undergoing some drastic changes at the moment, as you can see, and it's still being built. And I do prefer this to the original station buildings, which were just Medcalf kits. I know it had a character of its own, but this is just something a little bit special. And why am I revamping it? Well, it's all because of a certain station I built 3 years ago. Because when I first started out building this layout, all I was going to do was just buy buildings and just plonk them on the layout, until I got the knack of scratch building. I mean, I'm not going to go too much into depth of this station because it's still undergoing a rebuild. So this is, or was, station 2. This is station 3, High Shields. I do like what I've done here. I think here is where my scratch building come kit bash came to the fore, with a few of the buildings here. I don't think I'll be changing anything here because I'm happy with it. It's simple as that. The High Shields main station building is almost a true representative of the original, except we can see the bricks, and the original was all painted in white, and it did have the extra bit on the side there, which I think was the toilets. So yeah, so I'm quite happy and content with that station, although there's no detail inside the buildings at all, nothing. I think I painted the inside, and that was just about it. You can even see the cables running up to the LEDs. So yeah, so I'm content with High Shields. Did do a few kit bashes here. The pub over there, the Railway Inn. Let's just zoom in. You can see there. There. So that's just it was a shopfront building, which I converted into a pub, and that's a Medcalf kit. And all the rest are just kits, really. And but it does make the scene, and that's what it's all about when you build a model railway, is trying to make a scene and create a look of what you want with your layout. So it has everything here. It has a gatekeeper's cottage. It has a bungalow. It has a church, which is just coming into view now, which is St. Hilda's. Now, this church probably be the only thing I would change in this area, because it's not a true representation of the church St. Hilda's of South Shields. Well, saying South Shields, but the High Shields station was the closest to it. But yeah, so that I will definitely be changing at some point. And moving on, the vicarage. That was my very, very first attempt at scratch building using odds and ends from mid-carve kits. Now, something that is missing from the station is a signal box. Now, we've got a gatekeeper's cottage there, over there, which looks after the road crossing. But we've got two signals, one either side the platform, one there. And we have another one around the other side. If we just take you around there, and we have a signal there. But what it's missing is a signal box. Now, I know High Shields had a signal box. So at some point we will come back here just to build a signal box and redo the church. I've got a place where I can put the signal box, and I have got a spot for it, which will probably be about here. So we will be coming back to High Shields at some point, and we've had a lot of videos done over the years here at High Shields, because this is where the train spotters hang out. So most of the stories always seem to start from High Shields. So without me waffling on too much, this is station number 3. And number 4 on the list is South Shields. It's because of this station I am redoing the Tyne Dock over there. You can just see it in the background. So let's have a closer look at South Shields. The inspiration behind me building the station was basically a childhood memory, getting on a DMU for the first time, and it was here at South Shields station. So that's why I decided to build it, but I never thought it would come out anything like this. There was a lot of research, and I've had a lot of help from subscribers about some of the information that I needed to build this station, especially the buildings on platform 2, this side you're looking at now. And I just can't thank the guys who gave me the photographs and information regarding that. So that's down to George Tullin and John Cudahy, just to name a couple. But yeah, it took 18 months to build, God knows how many hours. If you wanted to do it, build this again, it would probably take the same. But it was built during COVID, when I had plenty of time on my hands to build this. So this building was built in 1879, 5 years after Tyne Dock was built, because the terminus station for South Shields was High Shields. believe it or not. We're now looking through the station from the other end, so this is where the signal box is, and I had a lot of help with that as well, especially the detailing inside and the chimney press that was on the back, which many photographs that are around doesn't show the chimney breast and pots on the back. Now, originally this station would have come at least another 20 metres further this way, but because of restrictions, the wall is a lot shorter on this side. But apart from that, it's a good true representation. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to lift off the roof so you can actually see the scale of the roof, because you see it there, you don't know how big this roof is. Now it's just under a metre, so if I just lift this off, you can see the size of this thing. And it's not straight, it's curved. And it's quite light, you know, considering what it's made from. So we're just looking at the roof from the outside, and it's still intact because it's directly in front of the window. So if I just lift the camera up, you can see the window there. So the sun comes directly on this roof, and I was expecting over the years that it's been here that some of these spans would split or anything like that, but it's still in good condition and intact. A little bit of a fact for you, there's 38 spans across the whole station, and I used about 8 meters of 1 mil tick rod and 7 meters worth of 0.8 tick rods. So there's 2 different sizes of tick rods there. A little bit of trivia for you. Moving on to the other side of the station, thought we'd have a good in-depth look of the interesting features that we have this side, especially all these chimney pots. It's like something out of Mary Poppins. Oh, and there she is. Whoops, Mary Poppins. Yes, so got to have a sense of humour when you're building a model, really, I tell you. If we lift off this roof, we can see all the cables that feed all the LEDs for this side of the building. And those of you that know South Shields, I mean, when I was a lad at South Shields, the clock tower was not there, or this canopy. They were both destroyed during the Second World War, and they never did replace them. So I have built it this way just because it just looks, well, as it did before the war, and there's something about it. It's just its quirkiness. And its detail. Even the railings that go along the top there. Just little things that weren't around when I was a lad, when I took my first train ride from this station. So this was the building that changed it all for me, I think. I mean, ever since this building, I have kind of upped my game regarding scratch building. Even when I built this, all the rooms have got detail in. So this is the, I think it's the lost property or lost property room, porter's office, I think. Then we have the gents next door. Just make out the vinyls there. See, even now when I look back, I keep forgetting what I've actually put in to these rooms. Station master's office. And is there. No, that's not the station master's office. That's the station master's office. I can't remember where everything was. But you know what I mean. This is the inspiration behind everything I've followed. And there's the ladies. You can actually see the sinks in the ladies. Right, so we come back. So that's the ladies' waiting room next door to the ladies. And then we've got the booking office there. And then we've got, if I just move this vehicle out of the way, and then we can see where you get your tickets from. So yeah, like I said, this has been the inspiration that for everything that followed. And that is station number 4, South Shields. And here we are, we're at Jarrah Road, number 5 on the list. And this was never in the planning for the North Eastern. It came about because when I used to do the video footage for Stevenson's Bank, you could see the handrail, and you can still see the handrail partially, which is the entrance and exit to the loft. And so I decided to do something about it, and hence why we have Jarrah Road. Quite a recent build. So let's have a look at Jarrah Road. Some interesting facts about this station. It took about 8 months to build, and it's only been on the layout for about 14 months, I think, maybe a year and a half. So yeah, some interesting features as well. It's got a round window, which is made out of a Doughty seal, and so a nice large window at the front there. If you look through that, you can see that intricate staircase that was made, which had to be made in two halves and only assembled when the building was going together. And yeah, so we have 4 rooms. Like I said, we've got the refreshments room there, we've got a waiting room there. Here we've got the station master's office, and with a typewriter. See, so I have done a typewriter before, and it's got a secretary sitting at the desk, if we can make her out. No, I think I've got that wrong. I think the secretary's downstairs with a typewriter. Yeah, there she is. Just about make her out over there. There she is, and there's the typewriter. Yep, there she is, and there's the typewriter. Yes, there was a lot of changes during this build. especially the front. I mean, originally the steps were just going to come straight out, but I split them so the steps could go either way, and that made the entrance look a bit more interesting. And this is a view we don't see every day, where the trains come into the station. I'm going to try and get down to track level without hitting the signals. And there we go. A different type of canopy used here. And I used the Pico columns for this one. And it's quite a small station. You can only get about 3 coaches into platform 1. Platform 2, as you can see, just about squeezing 2 coaches. That just shows you how small this station is. But it hides the banister, which is just behind it, which is here. And that's the only reason why the station's there, to be honest. So this is station number 5, Jarrah Road. Well, what can I say about Little Haven? I should be building this now and not Tyne Dog. But that's the way the cookie crumbles, as they say. And poor old Mr. Gibbs there, Station Master Gibbs, all he's got is a little hut. And yep, this platform was cut the same time as the Jarrah Road platforms were cut. And I was hoping to go from Jarrah Road to New Haven. And obviously that hasn't happened. But this is going to be another unique station. So I'm quite looking forward to doing this next. This will definitely follow Tyne Dock, because there's a lot to do here. This baseboard remains untouched since 2016, except for me putting in the new runaround loop. Well, about a year or so ago. So yeah, the plans for this will be a single building with a small canopy on the front and a ticket office. And where we've got a cutout here, that's going to be for a footbridge to come across from there to here somewhere, so people can get onto the platform from this side. But there'll be some railings or something along there which will take you into the building. Anyway, that's one of the ideas, but that might change. So there's a lot of work to do at Little Haven. The baseboard's got to come out by another 120 mil or so. So yeah, another station to look forward to. And then after this, who knows? But I'm expecting this to take me about a year or two, because there's not only the, like I said, the station, there's the extension, there's the water to put in here, because there's a river there, as you can see. And I've got to sort out the back scenes, paint a river in, that sort of thing. And then there's the ballasting to do along the 5 bridges. So, there's a lot to look forward to. And this is Little Haven. station number 6. Right, so here we are. We're almost at the end of the video. Hope you've enjoyed the tour of the 6 stations of the Northeastern, and thank you for the suggestion. It's going to help out a lot of new subscribers who have not seen as much of the layout that there is to see, because we've been mostly focusing on Tyne Dock next door. So yeah, thank you for the suggestion, and I hope you've enjoyed what you've seen. Now, if you've got any other suggestions of areas you might want to see or anything, please let them know. Let us know and drop them in the comments box. Right, I think that's all from me. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you again soon. Bye for now. Bye.